You know when you have those like little superficial pimples, like, eh, those are cool.
Not a big deal. Whatever.
But like cystic acne, like especially before like a big day.
Yeah.
It's like,
you know what I call that?
What?
Big cyst
energy.
Hi, I'm Rose.
And I'm Nahal.
And welcome back to Skin ID, where today we're getting down and dirty with
cystic acne. Now, before we get into it, don't forget to like and subscribe, leave some comments below.
We'd love to hear from you so we know what else to bring to the table next.
You have a voice, use it. How do I know I cystic acne?
How do you know if you have cystic acne? We get asked that quite a bit, actually.
And I think a lot of people, like, they think, like, oh my god, I have cystic acne. But when you have it, you know.
You know.
Super swollen pimples that are, like, deep. They're maybe tender to the touch.
They're red.
They stand out.
All acne, whether or not it's a clogged pore, a regular acne breakout, or a cystic breakout, it all starts with a clogged pore. And there are multiple factors for clogged pores. Some of it could be genetic.
Definitely genetics play into this. So sometimes, you know, you don't get a choice in this. I think with cystic acne, it was probably somebody else in your family that also had it. And then there's other factors like in your life that can contribute.
Like hormones.
Oh okay, my gosh.
You guys, I see all the time, a lot of the times when cystic acne is happening is when it's a hormonal type of breakout. Like if you have your main breakout patterns in your cheeks, your jawline, your chin, your mouth area, that is pretty much a dead giveaway that there's a hormonally influenced situation going on. That's also when you see a lot of deep, painful lesions. There's not really predicting how an acne breakout is going to evolve.
But like with like cystic acne, like there's most of it you don't have control over. There's people who like they're not using any pore clogging ingredients, like they're not, and like that's when at Curology, like I'm always trying to like, let's look at the whole thing. Like, okay, what's going on in your life? Have your hormones been changing?
What's your diet been
yeah.
like? Have you used any new skincare products?
You start a new job, are you stressed
yeah.
out?
Something that you have full control over, you guys, is making sure none of your skincare products has pore clogging ingredients in there. It all starts with a clogged pore. So let's eliminate some
yeah,
of the factors
for sure.
that causes yeah. clogged pores. Don't put anything like hydrocortisone on your pimples or triamcinolone, clobetasol. Those are all commonly prescribed topical steroids. And we wanna make sure we avoid that because it might look a little bit better when you are putting it
yeah.
on.
It's like initially like things are going great. Like,
but then you stop using it and it comes back with a vengeance and you guys, it is not okay.
It sounds like we're like an Olympic, like avoid steroids.
Clean bulking only.
Topical steroids.
There are some substances that make a skincare product feel so smooth.
God.
If we're talking about cleansers, the most common pore clogging ingredient that I'm seeing is something called sodium lauryl sulfate. And then for moisturizers, we see a lot of coconut oil and a lot of these moisturizers. There's one really funny chemical name. It's called like isopropyl myristate.
And there's, yeah.
Did I even pronounce that right?
I've never said it out loud. I just type it. We kind of need to be aware of, you know, what is actually in our products and what are they doing to our skin? Like I said, like I might be able to use that ingredient and be fine. Rose might use it and break out. If you can avoid it, why not just avoid it?
The takeaway of today is don't pick.
Oh my God.
Do not pop your pimples,
as
you guys.
I know everyone wants to do it, especially with like cystic acne. Like there's not usually even a head. So then they're like going at it and there's so much trauma to the skin.
And remember, when you're doing that, your body is then even further trying to repair itself.
Yeah.
So then it gets even more red and more inflamed and all of a sudden you're just delaying the healing cycle.
Everyone's skin heals differently. So you might heal with little ice pick scars, you might have rolling scars. When we talk about scarring, we're talking about like actual like leaving spots in your skin that are gonna last.
Holes in your skin.
Yeah.
That's scarring. But let's say we're here, you've picked out your acne, what are we gonna do next?
First of all, what is it gonna look like after? If it's just the redness and the brown marks, like we can work on that. The ingredients in your Curology formula may help, and time.
And patience.
And like sunscreen.
Because,
you know, you have this mark, then you're out in the sun, and things are just getting darker.
And if you are left with an actual depressed scar, but it's a true texture change.
Mm-hmm. That's what it is, yeah.
Because tretinoin stimulates that cell turnover, it also stimulates collagen, mm-hmm. and it just helps smooth over the texture.
Mm-hmm. You have this, like, angry lesion. Like, how do we, like, cool and calm it down? So, like,
spot yeah. patches.
Oh, love.
Spot patches
love.
Are key. You wanna make sure it's protected.
Yes, and what does it prevent you from doing?
picking.
Exactly.
Guys, a spot patch will help draw out some of the pus that's in there and help decrease some of the inflammation.
I know, sometimes when I take it off, I'm
it's so satisfying though.
I know. And then it's like, this little thing just did that? Like, it's pretty amazing.
One way to really help soothe that cystic acne breakout is a cool compress. So it's exactly what it sounds like. You put a little ice cube, maybe in a Ziploc bag. Make sure the bag is clean, of course. Make sure your skin's clean. You can just hold it on your skin for, what, 20, 30 seconds at a time.
And like, you can tolerate. Yeah, just the cold.
Put it back on again. It is going to be really cold. But it will help somewhat with decreasing the swelling and the inflammation that's happening. We said don't put on topical steroids, but an intralesional steroid injection is something completely different. Get that thing injected. It can only be done at a dermatologist's office in person, of course. We can't do it through our computer monitors.
Imagine
that.
Hello, just put your face close to the screen.
It might be a way of the future, you guys. We don't know. So what's cool about a Curology custom formula is not only is it going to help address the cystic breakout after it happens, but really we're trying to prevent these cystic breakouts from even happening
in the
first place, right? So these ingredients in the custom formulas are prescription. For example, there's clindamycin. It's probably the most commonly prescribed topical anti-acne medication out there. There's azelaic acid, niacinamide is in some of our formulas, which is
so soothing.
Amazing.
Yeah, your body's trying to like build all this inflammation and something closed, and we're just trying to open it up and just allow, you know, your skin to exist and to not have these trapped volcanoes, like I like to call them.
Trapped volcanoes. That's a colorful explanation. We are always our worst critic. Am I right?
No, always.
We're just like so hard on ourselves. So
we look in the mirror and we're like, it's
this
over.
This is what I see. This is all these little bad things that we see. The reality is, you're probably one of the only ones, if not the only person that notices it in that sort of severity.
Yeah.
No one's going to notice your skin as much as you do. So try to just remember, you're always your own worst critic, and people will see you in a much more beautiful light usually than how you see yourself.
We're here to help you long term. Yeah, in the beginning it's hard and we're gonna need to really be kind of aggressive in the beginning to get it under control, but we can get you to a place where, you know, you feel good and you feel excited to walk into a room.
Can I just say, like, one of the best things about being a Curology provider is when I get a patient who checks in.
Yes.
Like, 3 months into their Curology formula, and like when you compare their before and after photos, first of all, yes, you can see the changes in their skin. But what's even cooler is like the attitude.
I was gonna say the smile.
The confidence is just there all of a sudden. And when I see that, you guys, that makes my day.
Like, let's take a look and give some props to like you. I'm always like, great work if you did this.
Self-love is so important.
And I think a lot of people will be like, I want perfect skin, but like,
no such thing.
Perfect
exists.
Skin? What is perfect skin? And like, we're human.
You know what perfect skin is, Nahal?
Fake.
What? A filter. Have you heard of glass skin? Have
yes.
you ever been asked?
Yes! I've been asked that multiple times. Like,
I'm like, glass skin.
I'm like, you
honey.
Need pores. Like, you guys, we need them. Like, it's not
like to survive.
No one's getting rid of your pores.
No.
Yeah.
We're just not.
Like, bye. Like, we're like, bye, pores.
Okay, so I think that covers cystic acne. What do you
think?
We
just covered like a beast, like cystic acne. I know that was a lot of info. If you guys have any comments, anything
questions,
you want, like we want to hear. Leave a comment, like subscribe. Until next time, like
so
see you soon.
Well.